One at Aprille with a shoure soote, the droghte of March hath perced to the roote, and badded every veyne in swich licóur, of which vertú engendred is the floor. Whan Zephirus sing with his swain the breeth, in spirit hath in every holt and heeth the tender crups, and the youngest son hath in the ram his halve course a roote. And small fools make in melodia, that sleep in the night with open ear, so pricketh them nature in her courages, than long in folk to gone on pilgrimages, and palmeres were to seeken strange strandes, to ferne halwes couth in sundry landes, and specially from every sheer resende of Engelon to Canterbury they wende. The holy blissful martyr were to sinka, that em hath halpen, when the day were sinka. Befill that in that season on a day, in sooth work at the tabard as he lay, ready to wend in my pilgrimage, to Canterbury with full devoun courage. At nicht was come into that hostelria, well 29 in a compagnia, of sundry folk be aventure falla, in fellowship and pilgrims were they all, that toward Canterbury walden rida. The chambers and the stables were in weeda, and well we were in easing at the best. And shortly, when the sunna was to rest, so had he spoken with him every chan, that he was of her fellowship anon, and made forward early for to rise, to take her way there as he yun the visa. But natheless will he have team and spassa, that he further in the stall passa. May think it accordant to resume, to tell you all the condition of each of them, so as it same it may, and which they were in, and of what degree, and eke in what array that they were in, and at a knicht that wally first begin. A knicht there was, and that a worthy man, that for all the team that he first began, to read anon he loved chivalry, truth and honour, freedom and courtesy. Full worthy was he in his lord as were, and thereto had he ridden no man fair, as well in Christendom as in heathenness, and ever honored for his worthiness. At all a sound he was when it was won. Full of the team he had the bard begun, above in all the nations in Prusa. In Leto had he raised and in Russa, no Christian man so oft of his degree. In Gernan at the Sejic had he be, of Algezir and ridden in Belle Maria. At Lias was he and at Santa Lia, when they were wound and in the grain the sea, at many a noble army had he be. At mortal battles had he been 15, and fuchten for our faith at Tramesena, in least trees and they slain his foe. The silke worthy knicht had been also, some time with the lord of Palatia, again another heathen in Turkey, and evermore he had a sovereign priest. And thought that he were worthy, he was wise, and of his part as meek as is a maid. He never yet no villainy ne said, in all his life unto no manner weight. He was a very perfect gentle knicht. But for to telling you of his array, his horse were good, but he was not gay. A fustian he wearied a jupon, albismo terried with his hammer joan, for he was late come from his viage, and went for to done his pilgrimage. With him there was his son, a young squire, a lover and a lusty bachelor, with locks cruel as they were laid in pressa. Of 20 years of age he was, I guess. Of his stature he was of even length, and wonderly deliver and of great strength. And he had been some time in Chivachia, in Flanders, in Artois, and Picardia, and born him well, as of so little spasa, in whom to standen in his land in grassa. Embrooded was he, as it were, a maid, all full of fresh flowers, wind and rain. Singing he was, or floating all the day, he was as fresh as is the month of May. Shared was his goon with slaves long and weeda, well could he sit on horse and fair arena. He could a song as mag and well indeed, just and dance and well portray and read. So hoot he lufte that beneath der talla, he slept none more than dot a nicht in galla. Courtes he was, luli and serve sambla, and carved before his father at the tambla. A Yeoman had he and servant namu, a danting for him list to read the soo, and he was clad in coat and hood of green. A sheaf of pink og arwas, breeth and kenna, under his belt he bar full thriftily. Well could he dress his tackle, Yeoman knee. His arwas drooped knocked with feathers loo, and in his hand he bar a michty boo. A knot he'd had he with a broon visanja, of all the craft well could he all the sanja. Upon his arm he bare a gay brassiere, and be his seed a sword and a bocalere, and on that other scene again the gear, harnessed well and sharp as point of spear, a Christopher on his breast of silver chin. And horn he bare, the baldric was of green, a forster was he, soothly, as he guess. There was also a nun, a prioress, that of her smiling was full simple and coy. Her greatest oath was bunt be Saint Eloy, and she was clepid Madam Eglantine. Full well she sung the service of divina, and tuned in her nose full semely, and French she spake full fair and fettestly, after the school of Stratford at the Boo, for French of Paris was to hear un knoo. At meta well it talked was she with all, she laid no marcel from her lips fall. Ne wet her fingers in her sauce dimp. Well could she carry a marcel and well kemp, that no drop ne fill up on her breast. In courtesy was said full muchel her lest. Her over lip a weeped she so clean, that in her cup there was no ferding sin of grace when she drunken had her droughte. Full samely after her maid she rauchte. And sickerly she was of great despart, and full pleasant and amiable of part, and painted her to counterfeit the chair of court, and to bend the statlage of manner, and to been holden digne of reverence. But far to speaking of her conscience, she was so charitable and so pitous, she walled away that she saw a moose, caught in a tram if it were deigned or blend. Of smaller hundes had she thought she fed, with roasted flesh or milk and wastel bread. But sore wit she if one of him were dead, or if men smoothed with a year the smerta, and all was conscience and tendre herta. Full semely her wimple pinch it was, her nose a treatise, her een grey as glass, her mouth full small, and thereto soft and red. But sickerly she had a fair forehead, it was almost a span abroad the true, for hardly she was not undergrew. Full fetus was her cloak as he was war. Of small coral about her arm she bar, a pair of bedes gouded all with grain, and thereon hang a brooch of gold full sheen, on which there was first wreathed a crooned A, and after armor vinched omnia. Another noon with Hera had she, that was her chaplain and priestess tree. A monk there was, a fair for the mystery, an outre dare that loved the venery, a manly man to ben an abbot able. Full many a dainty horse had he in stable, and when he rode, men micht his brindle hair, ging glennen a whistling a wind als clear, and ache as lewd as doth the chapel bell, there as this lord was caper of the cell. The rule of Saint Mar are of Saint Benet, because that it was old and some nil strained, this ilke monk laid all the things pass, and held after the new world the spas. He have not of that text a bullet hen, that saith that hunters been not holy men, ne that a monk, when he is rich a less, is licked till a fish that is waterless. This is to say, a monk out of his cloister. But ilke text held he not worth an oyster, and he said his opinion was good. What shall his study and mark himself in wood, upon a book and cloister all way to poor, or swinking with his hands and labour, as Austin did, who shall the world be serving? Let Austin have his swing to him reserving. Therefore he was a precasur a richt, grey hundes he had as swift as fool in flicht, a pricking and a hunting for the hara was all his lust for no cost wall this bar. He sake his slave as perfiled at the hand, with grace and that the finest of a land, and far to fasten his hood under his chin, he had of gold he broke the full curious pin, a loof not in the greater end there was. His head was bald as shoon as any glass, and ache as fast as he had been in mind. He was a lord full fat and in good point, his ain stem and rolling in his hain, that stamen as a furnace of a lane, his boat assumed his horse in great stand. No certainly he was a fair prelad, he was not pale as a farpined ghost. A fat swan loofed he best of any rost, his palfrey was as brown as is a berry. A friar there was, a wantoon and a merry, a limitour, a full solemn man. In all the ardorous fur is none that can, so much loved alliance and fair langage. He had the madful mania marriage, of younger woman at his own cost. Unto his ardor he was a noble past. Full well beloved and familiar was he, with frank lanes over all in his country, and eke with worthy woman of the tune, for he had poor of confession, a said himself more than a courant, for of his ardor he was licentiant. Full sweetly heard he confession, and pleasant was his absolution. He was an easy man to give penance, thereas he wished to have a good pedance. For unto a poor ardor far to give, is signet that a man is well is shriven. For if he yaf, he durst the man abound, he wished that a man was repentant. For many a man so hard is of his heart, he may not weep, although him sore smerta. Therefore, instead of weeping and prayers, men mood give silver to the poor friars. His tippet was a farset full of knives, and pinnes for to give in fair weaves. And certainly he had a murry note, well could he sing and play in on a ronda, of yeadings he bare utterly the breeze. His neck of wheat was as the floor de lees, that though he strong was as a champion. He knew the taverns well in every tune, and every chastelier and tapestere, with an a lazar or a bengestere. For unto switch a worthy man as he, accorded not as be his faculty, to have with sick Lazar's acquaintance. It is not honest, it may not advance, for to dealing with no swinch parella, but all with rich and sellers of vitella. And overall, there is profit shall arise, courtes he was and lowly of service, there nas no man nowhere so virtuous. He was the best beggar in his house, and yaf a certain firma for the ground. None of his brethren came there in his hound, for though a widow had noch the shoe, so pleasant was his in principio, yet wald he have a farthing ere he went. His purchase was well better than his rent, and rage he could as it were rich the whelp. In love days there could he muchel help, for there he was not link a cloister rare, with a threadbare comb as is a poor scholar, but he was like a maester or a pump. Of double worsted was a semi-comb, that runded as a bell out of the press. Somewhat he lips in for his want to ness, to mark his English sweet upon his tongue. And in his harping, when that he had a sung, his e'en twinkle in his head a reached, as down the stairest in the frosty night. This worthy limitour was clepid who bared. A merchant was there with a forked beard, in Montelay and he and horses sand, upon his head a flounderish bever hand, his boat is clasped fair and fettishly. His raisons his back full solemnly, soon ingle way the increase of his winning. He wore the sea were kept for anything, betwixt a middle burk and or a well. Well could he in his challenge a shield a sell. This worthy man full well his wit be sent, there wist no wish that he was in debt, so stately was he of his governance, with his bargainess and with his chevisance. For sooth he was a worthy man with all, but sooth to sin in no two men him call. A clerk there was of Oxenford also, that unto logic had a long ago. As lena was his horse as his racca, and henas not richt fati under tanka, but looked hollow and dertus sobre lee. Full threadbar was his overest corte pie, for he had gaten him yet no benefissa, ne was so wardly for to have a fissa. For him was lever have at his bed this hand, 20 bocas clad in blank or rain, of Aristotle and his philosophia, than Rubus Ringe or Fittle or Gay Sotria. But albeit that he was a philosopher, yet had he but little gold in coffre, but all that he missed of his friend is hent, and bocas on unlearning he had spent, and busily gone for the soulless prayer, of him that yaf him wherewith Toscalea. Of study talk he must cur and most heda. Nocht over spak he more than was neda, and that was said in form and reverenza. And short and quing and full of his sentenza, soon ingen moral vertú was his speech, and gladly wald he learn and gladly teach. A sergeant of the law war and wees, that often had a been at the parvis, there was also full rich of excellenza. This great he was, and of great reverenza, his same it swins, his wardes weren't so wise. Just this he was, full often in a Caesar, be patent and be plain commission. For his science and for his hake renown, of face and rubus had he money own. So great a purchaser was nowhere known, and was face simply to him in effect. His purchasing which done had been in fact. Nowhere so busy a man as he there nas, and yet he seemed busier than he was. In termes had he cas and domes all, that from the team of King William were fall. Thereto he could indeed and make a thing, there could no which pinch at his writing, and every statute could he plain be runt. He rode but homely in a medley conta, girt with a saint of silk with bars small. Of his array till he no longer tall. A frank lane was in his compagnia, which was his beard as is the day ye see, of his complexion he was sanguine. Well loved he by the marrow a soup in wean, to live in the lead was ever his woon, for he was Epicurus una soon, that held opinion that plain the lead was very felicity perfine. And whose held there, and that a grain was he, St. Julian he was in his country. His bread, his all, was always after own, a better invented man was nowhere known. Without tobacco mate was never his house, of fish and flesh, and that so plentivous, it snewed in his house of mead and drink, of all the dainties that men could think. After the sundry seasons of the year, so challenged he his maid and his souper. Full many a fat partridge had he in mew, and many a brame and many a loose in stew. Where was his cook but if his sounds so were, poignant and sharp and ready all his gear? His table d'armand in his hall alway, stood ready covered all the long day. At sessions there was he lord and seer, full of the team he was knicht of the sheer. An anlas and a gypser all of silk, hang at his girdle, wheen as morna milk. A sheriff had he been, and a cantour, was nowhere switch a worthy vavasour. An haberdasher and a carpenter, a web, a deer, and a tapisser, and they were clothed all in a livery, of a solemn and a great fraternity. Full fresh and new her gear a peaked was, her knives were a chapped knocked with brass, but all with silver, roughed full clean and well, her girdles and her pouches every dell. Well same at each of him a fair burgess, to sitting in a yield hall on a dais. A verit for the wisdom that he can, was sharply for to ben an alder man. For cattle had they enough and rent, and eke her weavers what it will assent. And el certain were a thing to blame. It is full fair to ben acclaimed, madame, and gone to vigilias all before, and have a mantle royal in she bore. A cock they had with him for the nonnas, to buy the chickens with the mariponas, and put her margin tart and galingala. Well, could he knew a droughte of London alla? He could roast and seethe and broil and fria, mak en mar true and will bang a pia. But great harm wasn't as it thought the me, that on his sheen the marmal had a hay, for blank man gear that mad he with the best. A shipman was there warning fair be westa, for auch the wood he was of there the mootha. He rode upon a runcy as he cootha, in a goon of falding to the knee. A dagger hanging on a lass and he, about his neck under his arm a doon. The hood so mare had man his hue all broon, and certainly he was a good fellow. Full many a draught of wean had he a draw, fro beer to ward will that a chapman slay. Of nees a conscience to gain no came. If that he fought and had the here hand, be what he sent him home to every land. But of his craft to reckon well his tides, his streams and his dangers him besides, his hair bear one his moon, his load menanja, there nas non switch from hulla to gertanja. Our day he was and wees to undertaka, with many a tempest had his beard been shaka. He knew of the heavens as they were, from Godland to the camp of Finisterre, and every creek in Britain and in Spain. His barge clip it was the mouth of Lena. With us there was a doctor of physing, in all this world ne was there none him ling, to speak of physic and of surgery, for he was grounded in astronomy. He kept his patient a full great deal, in whores be his magic naturel. Well could he for to nend the ascendant of his images for his patient. He knew the cause of every malady, were it of hot or cold or moist or drear, and where they engendered and of what humour. He was a very perfect practiseur, the cause he knew and of his harm the runta, and on he of the sick man his bunta. Full ready had he his apothecaries, to send him drugs and his letuaries, for each of him an other for to win. Her friendship nas not new to begin. Well knew he the old Esculapius, and the Escarides, and Ingrufus, old Hippocras, Halle, and Gallien, Serapion, Resis, and Avicen, Averroes, Damasian, and Constantine, Bernard, and Catistin, and Gilbertine. Of his dieta mesurable was he, for it was of no superfluite, but of great nursing and digestible. His study was but little on the Bible. In sanguine and in Percy glad was all, lined with taffeta and with sendal. And yet he was but easy of dispenser, he kept that he won in pestilence. For God in physic is a cordial, therefore he loved gold in special. A good wife was there of Basin the bath, but she was soon till deaf, and that was scath. Of cloth making she had a switch and hound, she passed him of Ibris and of gown. In all the parish wife ne was there known, that to the offering before her should have gone. And if there deen, certain so wroth was she, that she was out of all and charity. Her cover chiefs full fine were of grund, he durst swear they weighed 10 pound, that on a Sunday were upon her hen. Her hosen were enough in scarlet wren, full straighty tied and shoes full moist and new. Bald was her face and fair and red of hue. She was a worthy woman on her leave, whose bonds at church door she had a fever, without another company in youth, but thereof needed none to speak as nooth. And trees had she been at Jerusalem, she had a passed many a strange stream. At Rome she had been and at Bologna, in Gales at St. James and at Cologne. She could a mutual of wandering be the way. Gatoth it was she, soothly for to say. Upon an ambler easily she sat, it wimpled well, and on her head and hat, as broad as is a buckler or a targe, a footman tell about her hip is large, and on her feint a pair of spores sharp. In fellowship well cool she lauch and carpa. of remedies of loom she knew perchance, for she could of that art the older dance. A good man was there of religion, and was a poor person of a tune, but rich he was of holy thought and work. He was also a learned man, a clerk, that Christ's gospel truly will preach. His parsons devoutly want he teach. Benign he was, and wonder diligent, and in adversity full patient, and swich he was a privin of the seethes. For loath were him to cursing for his teethes, but rather while he even out of dunta, unto his poor parsons abunta, of his offering and ink of his substance. He could in little thing have sufficiency. It was his parish and houses were asunder, but he ne left the not for rain ne thunder. In sickness nor in mischief to visit, the fairest in his parish much and lint, upon his fane and in his hand the staff. This noble ensample to his shame he yaf, that first he wrought and afterward he taught. Out of the gospel he thoward this cauchta, and this figure he added ecter to, that him gone rusta what shall earen do. For if a priest be fool on whom we trusta, no wonder is a lewd man to rusta. And sham it is if a prestanga came, a sheeten shepherd and a clean a shame. We locked a priest in sample for to give, be his cleanness who that his shame should live. He said and not his benefits to hear, and laid his ship encumbered in the mere, and ran to London unto Saint Apulus, to seek in him a chantry for souls, or with a brotherhood to ben withhold. But dwelt at home and kept well his fold, so that the wolf ne madded not miscarry. He was a shepherd and not a mercenary. And though he holy were and vertuous, he was to sinful men, not despotous, ne of his speech a dangerous ne digna, but in his teaching discreet and benigna. To drown folk to heaven be fairness, be good and sample, this was his business. But it were any person obstinate, whatso he were of heek or look astand, him wald his snibben sharply for the nones. A better priest the true that nowhere none is. He waited after no pomp and reverence, ne marked him a specied conscience. But Christ's lore and his apostles 12 he taught, but first he followed it himself. With him there was a Ploughman was his brother, that had a lad of doom full many a father. A true swinker and a good was he, living in peace and perfect charity. God loved he best with all his holy heart, at all the times though him gamed or smerta, and than his neighbor reached as himself. He wald the thresh and derto dig and delve, for Christus sang for every poor wicht, withouten here if it lay in his meat. His teeth is paid he full fair and well, both of his proper swing and his cantel, and at a barn he rode upon the mare. There was also a Reeve and a Miller, a Sumner and a Pardoner or so, a Manciple and myself, there were no more. The Miller was a stute girl for the nuns, full big he was a brown and ink of bones. That proved well, for overall there he came, at wrestling he well to have all way the ram. He was short-shouldered, broad, a thick a knar, there was no door that he not have of her. Or break it at a renning with his hen. His beard as any sow or fox was red, and there to brown as though it were a span. Upon the cob reached off his nose he had a weird, and thereon stood a tuft of hairs, red as the bristles of a sow's ears. His nose had there less black were and weed. A sword and a buckler bar he be his seed. His mouth as great was as a grain for nays. He was a jangler and a gollier days, and that was most of sin and harlotries. Well could he steal in corn and toll in trees, and yet he had a thumb of gold per day. A wheen could on a blue hood wear it hay. A bag of people could he blue and soon, and therewithal he brought us out of tune. A gentle Manciple was the wrath a templar, of which a chanters make the tank exemplar, for to be wise in being of vitella. For whether that he paid or took vitella, all God he waited so in his acharmed, that he was a before and in good stand. Now is not that of God of full fair grassa, that which a lewd man as wind shall passa, the wisdom of an hemp of learned men. Of maestres had he mouth and three stem, that weren of law expert and curious. Of which there were a deucin in that house, were they to bench stewards of rent and land, of any lord that is in England, to make him leave be his proper good, in honour did the less but if he were wood, or leave scarcely as him least desire, and able for to help in all shira, in any cast that make to fall or rampa. And yen this Manciple set here all their campa. The Reeve was a slender choleric man. His beard was shav as knee as ever he can. His hair was be his heirs full round the shorn. His tongue was docked like a pressed beforn. For long were his legs and full lena, the link staff, there was no calf in sinna. Well could he keep a gerner and a binna, there was none outdoor could on him winna. Well wist he be the droghte and be the rain, the yielding of his seed and of his grain. His lord is shame, his name, his diarrhea, his swine, his horse, his stoor, and his poultrya, was holy in its revis governinga, and be his covenant ye after reckoninga, since that his lord was 20 years of anja. There could no man bring him in arre ranja. There nas belief ne heard nor author hinna, that he ne knew his slicht and his govina. They were a dread of him as of the death. His wounding was full fair upon an heath, with green trees the shadwood was his plaza. He could better than his lord perchance. Full rich he was a storied privily. His lord well could he place in subtly, to even lain him of his own a good, and have a thank and yet a cund and hold. In youth he had a learn a good mystere. He was a well good reeth, a carpenter. This Reeve sat upon a full good stand, that was all palmily grey and heeth as scant. A long sir good of pears upon he had, and be his seed he bar a rusty blanda. Of Norfolk was this Reeve of which he tell, beside the tune men clip in Valdeswella. To get he was as his frere a bunta, and ever he rode the hindrest of a ruta. A summoner was there with us in that plaza, that had a fiery cherub in his fassa, for south of flame he was with Eyan Narwa. As hot he was and lecherous as a sparwa, with scarlet bruise black and peeled beard, of his visage children were affaired. There nas quicksilver, litarch, ne brimstone, borras, ceruse, ne oil of tartrenone, ne oin the man that wal the cleanse and pinta, that him make helping of his huelcas huinta, nor of the knob a sitting on his jenkas. Well loved he garlic, oinons, and iglengas, and far to drink in strong wine, red as blood, that wal he speak and cree as he were wood. And one that he well drunken had the wine, than while he spake no word but Latin. A few termes had he, two or three, that he had learned out of some decree. No wonder is he heard it all the day, and eke knowing well who thought that Jay can clap in one as well as can the pumpa. But whoso could an other thing him gropa, than had he spent all his philosophia, a question quid juris while he crea. He was a gentle harlot and a kinda, a better fellow shall the men not finda. He will the suffer for a quart of wine, a good fellow to have his concubine, a 12-month, and excuse him at the full privily a finch he could he pull. And if he found or where a good fellow, he will the teaching him to have none hour, in swinch cause of the archdeacon's curse. But if a man's soul were in his purse, for in his purse he shall the punished be. For since the archdeacon's hell, said he. But well he wot he lead richt in deda. Of cursing oft each guilty man him dreda, for curse was slay richt as a soiling savith, and also war him of a significavin. And down to Hade at his own Giza, the young girlis of the diocese, and knew her counsel, and was all her reign. A girl in Hade said upon his hen, as great as it were foreign and stanka, a bogler had he mad him of a canka. With him there rode a gentle pardonnere, of Runceval, his friend and his compere, that straight was coming fro the court of Rome. Followed his son, come hither, love Tommy. The sumner bar to him a stiff burdoon, was never tramp of half so great a soon. This pardoner had hair as yellow as wings, but smoothed hang as doth a streak of flings. Be unces hang his locks that he had, and therewith he his shoulders overspread. But thin it lay, be colpans on and on. But hood for jollity were red he known, for it was trussed up in his wallet. Him thought he rode all of the new agent, dishevels of his camp he rode all bar. Switch glaring ain had he as an har. A vernicler had his soon upon his camp, his wallet before him in his lamp, print full of pardon coming from room all hot. A voice he had as small as hat a goat. No bird had he, ne never should a have, as smooth it was as it were land a shave. It true he were a gelding or a mar, but of his craft fro Berwick into war, ne was there switch another pardonnere. For in his mall he had a pill with bear, which that he said was o'er a landy vale. He said he had a gobbet of the sail, that Saint Peter had when that he went upon the sea till Jesu Christ him hent. He had a cross of latun full of stones, and in a glass he had a pig's bones. But with these relics when that he found a poor person dwelling upon land, upon the day he got him more money than that a person got in Montes Tue, and thus, with vain flattery and jappas, he made the person and the people his appas. But truly to tell it not the last, he was in church a noble ecclesiasta. Well could he read a lesson or a story, but all the best he sung an offertory, for well he wist when that song was sung. He must appreach and well feel his tongue, to win the silver as a fool well could. Therefore he sung the merrily and loon. Now have he told you soothly in the clause, the stat, the re, the number and eke the cause, with that assembled was this compeg me, in sooth work at this gentle hostelry, that heek the tabard faster be the bell. But now is time to you far to tell, who that we barren us that ilke nicht, when we were in that hostelry a licht, and after while he tell of our viandja, and all the remnant of our pilgrimage. But first I pray you of your courtesy, that ye ne rented not me villainia, though that I plainly spake in this matter, to tell you her wardes and her chair, ne fuck I spake her wardes properly. For this ye knew and all so well as I, who so shall tell a tale after a man, he must rehearse as nigh as ever he can, every word if it be in his charge, I'll speak he never so rundelinch and large, or else he must tell his tale untrue, or feign a thing, or feign the wordest new. He may not spar, although he were his brother, he must as well say a word as another. Crispach himself full brown in holy brind, and well ye wod no villainy is in. Ek Plato saith, wo so can him renda, the wardes mot be cozened o the denda. Also I pray you to forgive it me, I'll have in not said folk in her degree, her in this tal as that they shall the stand. Me win the shard, ye may well understand. Great cheer mad ur host us every chan, and to the supper set he us anon. He served us with victual at the best, strong was the wind, and well to drink us lest. A seemly man ur host was withal, far to ben a marchal in an hall. A large man he was with ain stimp, a fairer burgess was there none in chimp. Bald of his speech and wheeze and well he taught, and of manhood him lacked a richt naught. Ecterto he was rich da merry man, and after supper playing he began, and spoke of mirth amongst other things, when that we had a mad were reckonings, and said thus, "Nu lardings truly, ye ben to me richt welcome heartily. For be me truth, if that I shall not lie, I saw not this year so merry a compagnia, atonus in this herberg as is new. Then well did don you mirtha wist the who, and of a mirthy amric new bethought, to don you is, and it shall cost a nacht. Ye gone to Canterbury, God you spend, the blissful martyr queen you remain. And well ye wold as ye gon be the way, ye sharpen you to talon and to play. For truly confart ne mirth is known, to read be the way doom as a stone. And therefore well ye maken you despart, as ye said erst, and don you some confart. And if you licketh alla be on the scent, far to standen at me judgment, and far to werken as ye shall you say, tomorrow when ye ridden be the way. No be me father Sula that is dead, but ye be merry, I wall ye view min hand. Hold up your handes withouten more spencha. Your counsel was not longer vertú sencha. Us took it was not worth to make it wise, and granted him withouten more rapies, and bade him say his worded as him lester. Lardings, quod he, nu hergneth for the besta, but daget nucht I pray you in disdain. This is the point to speak in short and plain, that each of you to sharte with her way, in this fian shall tell a talus tway, to Canterbury ward the main it so, and homer he shall tell an other two, of aventures that whilom han befall, and which of you that beareth him best of all, that is to say that telleth in this case, to less of best intents and most so las, shall have a supper at your aller cost, here in this place a sitting be this post, when that we come again from Canterbury, and for to make you the more merry, I wall myself and godly with you reen, reach that mean own a cost and be your gind. And whoso wall me judgment with say, shall pay all that we spendin be the way. And if ye would yourself that it be so, tell me anon withouten war this more, and ye will early shop me therefore. This thing was granted, and our oath a swore, with full glad heart and prayed in him also, that he will would yourself for dodo so, and that he will the ben our governor, and our talus judge and repartur, and set a supper at a certain price, and where will you let Ben at his devise, in heeth and loch, and thus be on ascent, with Ben accorded to his judgment. And thereupon the wind was fet anon, we drunken and to rest the winter John, withouten any langer tarrying. A morrow, when the day began to spring, up rose her host, and was her aller gong, and gathered us together all in a flock. And forth we rid in a little more than pass, unto the watering of Saint Thomas. And there our host began his horse arrest, and said, "Lardings, hearkneth, if you lest. Ye wold your forward, and ye you regard. If even song in marvel song accord, let say no who shall tell the first tal. As ever mote drink a wean or all, who so me rebel to me judgment, shall pay for all that be the way is spent. Nu draweth kun, that we fairer twin, he which that hath the shortest shall begin. Sir knicht, quod he, me maester and me lord, nu draweth kun, for that is mean accord. Cometh near, quod he, me ladi prioressa, and ye, sir clerk, lad be your shamfastnessa, ne studieth nacht, lay honto every man, and unto drawen every week began. And shortly for to tellen as it was, where it be aventure, or sword, or gas, the soote is this, the kund fill to the knicht, of which full bleeth and glad was every wight, and tell him most his tale as was resoon, be forward and be compass his yoon, as ye han heard what needeth war this moo. And when this good man saw that it was so, I say that wees was and obey the end, to keep his forward be his free ascend, he said, "Sin shall begin the gam, what welcome be the good the god this nam. Nu lat us rin, dan hergnet what is sea. And with that word, we ridden forth urwea, and he began with richta mericera, his tallen long, and send us e me hera.